to my channel and happy, happy new year. I don't even know where to start from. I know I've been off YouTube for such a very, very, very long time, and obviously the reasons why, which I guess is the whole essence of this video. So I'm basically going to be talking about my life updates, where I've been, why I haven't been posting on YouTube, and why I took, I think it was a six month break, probably more, I don't know, I'll check. But anyways, there's a lot of reasons why. sorry guys, I'm actually in a row because I just got back from work, so I decided to get comfy, make myself some tea. I actually have a cold, so there's that. Anyways, I won't even say I'm trying to give you guys some tea, but this isn't exactly gist as to where I've been and where I've been posting. But before I begin, I'd like to say Happy New Year if I haven't in the video or in the beginning of this video. Happy New Year, guys, and thank you guys so much for 100 subscribers. I am so grateful to everyone that subscribed to me. The plan is to be consistent this year with my posting and just being very present on all my platforms. But I think I'll discuss that when I'm speaking on my goals for 2020. So let's dive right into the video. So where have I been? What's been going on with me? Why I haven't like been posting on YouTube or Instagram? Why I fell off social media-ish? Okay, well, I think I was present on Twitter for a bit. I think, yeah, I was actually like more functional on Twitter, but not so much on Instagram or YouTube. I think Snapchat as well. This other platform, I was very much present. I just felt like I wasn't really ready to address, like, I mean, obviously a lot of people knew what happened or like had an idea as to why it went off and why I was silent, why I wasn't filming or posting pictures. But just to, I guess, involve you guys, but for those who don't know, I guess this video is for you. So I wasn't sure I was going to film this video, to be honest. I wasn't sure if I was going to cry or not, but I think I'm just going to go with the flow. If I cry, I cry. If I don't, then I guess is what it is. So 6 months ago, I went on a Euro trip for my 30th birthday with my sister and my older cousin. We went to London first. From London, we flew to Greece. From Greece, we flew to Italy. From Italy, Spain, Amsterdam. And it was in Amsterdam that my world just like turned upside down. So we were in Spain, from Spain, got into Amsterdam. I think it was at about, I think it was in the morning. Yeah, probably in the morning we landed. We had plans to obviously tour the city and like make restaurant reservations, because I think for everywhere I went to, I made reservations for dinner. So we actually had plans that day. And then I think later, like in the afternoon, I got a call from my auntie in London, because my sister was staying with my auntie in London and she was pregnant. She was the only one that's married in my family, one of my sisters. So yeah, she was pregnant, so she came to London to give birth. First of all, I'm not going to go into details as to what happened or the nitty-gritty of, like, you know, the event. I guess I'll just summarize what it is and what you guys need to know. So anyway, she was pregnant and she came to London to give birth and all of that. So we got a call from one of my aunties saying she wasn't feeling too good. I think she had a headache and she had thrown up and all of that. They had rushed her to the hospital, you know, and they said, you know, she said she just wanted to come back home and sleep. So I remember, like, I tried to call her. Me and my sister Maya tried to call her. She wasn't picking up, you know. I think eventually she picked up and said she was tired, she was wanting to sleep. Now, I think 10 minutes after that, that's when everything went, like, downhill. Anyways, long story short, they wanted to rush her to the hospital because she was unconscious. She had probably had a seizure. She was unconscious. She got to the hospital. So I think that's when, obviously at that time, we didn't know she had been rushed to the hospital. So one of my aunties called, but I think she didn't really want to go into details as to what happened. So she just said, oh, like it wasn't looking too good and all of that. But I don't know, for some reason when she said that, I just got this bad feeling that something bad had happened. And I remember at night, like my other auntie, one of my aunties called to speak to my older cousin, because she didn't want me and my sister to know what was going on at the time in the hospital, because I guess it was really, really bad. And I think at that time she was already in a coma. So I picked up the phone because she was downstairs. I picked up the phone and I was like, oh, hi auntie, what's going on? She was like, oh, nothing. Like, Claire just told, like, she'll talk to me later. I was like, what's going on? But then something just told me that, you know, she was gone. Or like there was something bad, I don't know. I can't explain it, but it was just a bad feeling. And then I remember my auntie saying that, well, she prayed for her, that it's really bad, she went into a coma. I remember screaming so much in the hotel, like I couldn't breathe for like 5 minutes. I was screaming, my sister was, everybody was crying. So I took a walk downstairs. That's when I just felt that, you know what? Okay, my memory is about to go off, so let me just delete some videos and get back. Okay guys, I'm back. Sorry, I had to do some videos because I didn't have any more space. But yeah, I don't know where I stopped. I think I stopped at, my auntie actually said like she was in a coma, it wasn't looking good. So, I remember taking a walk downstairs and I got into the lift and I just got this really, really bad feeling, which just felt like she was gone. And I couldn't explain it. So like, I was just like, why do I feel this way? I remember calling my best friend on the phone. I was telling him that, you know what, like, I don't know what's going on, but I feel like, you know, she's gone. He was telling me to be positive. Kept encouraging me. I was crying so much outside. I was just so distraught, you know. So I got back upstairs. I was trying to like book a flight out, so, like trying to get out of Amsterdam. There were no flights because it was late at the time. So we said, okay, we'll leave like first thing in the morning. I actually had to change our tickets. I think we changed our tickets obviously that night to go like the first flight the next morning. Me and my sister, we cried all through flights, cried when we got back to London. So we obviously went back home, dropped our stuff, and then went to the hospital. Got to the hospital, saw my sister, obviously she was unconscious. And then the doctors came in to speak to us and to tell us that, you know, it's not looking too good, but the chances are she probably won't wake up from a coma. I'm really crying. And like, even if she did, that you know, she'd probably be a vegetable. So at that point, you know, he was saying, in a way, I think he was saying his best way, going to just say their goodbyes and stuff. But he said before that he was going to do like final checks to check if there was any like brain activity. So it's probably around like 2 p.m. when he delivered the news to us, saying that, you know, like he wasn't looking good. So he was going to do the final checks by 5 p.m. That was like the longest 3 hours. I remember taking a walk out, like, I mean, I and my cousin, because I couldn't, everybody was just restless, you know, just waiting for 5 p.m. to come. So I had gone home to, like, I pulled my cousin out to go get some groceries, like something to eat and all that, and I was at the house when they were doing the checks, and my sister was there with my auntie and all of that, so they video called me, because we couldn't start going back because we were starting anyway, so I wanted to see like the whole process. So I did the whole like brain checks, like checked her, like obviously put like what's in my ear, the whole 411. Long story short, when she was unresponsive, they now pronounced the time of death. In the sense, obviously, she was brain dead. So I got to the, at that time, I think the line even cut off, so I didn't even hear that part. So I got to the hospital, and I saw my sister. going to fall, I was screaming, I was crying. And then at that time, my sisters were going back to the States and they had to change their flights because they already knew what was going on. So they all had to like reroute their journey and all that. And then, it was something. And then obviously my sisters, my family came to the hospital. And then my mom came, just kind of summarize everything. And I think as my mom came was when like her heart stopped. And I guess that was her way of like waiting for my mom or something. I don't know, that's what the doctor said anyway. And that was it really. So it was a really hard time for I and like my family. Went through everything. Obviously this is the first close family like we've ever lost, like in terms of my sisters obviously. So it's been tough, you know, trying to take each day as it comes hasn't been an easy one. Every day is a trigger. I mean, I feel like there is no day that goes by that we don't like think about her, think about last conversations. I remember like just when we were planning the funeral, by the way, the baby died as well. Her name was Gabrielle, but she died. When we were planning the funeral, I remember beating myself up that I didn't make it to her baby shower because I thought I was going to see her in London. But my sisters came down. And I feel like I'm so glad that we got to do that for her, you know, just before she passed. Sometimes it still feels surreal that she isn't here. Yes, but we're just happy and grateful that she's in a better place. And, we're just happy that she's in a better place. Obviously, we sat every day. Last year, we planned a family trip in December. I actually have that vlog, and I'll probably post that later. But it was a good time. It was hard because it was Christmas, and obviously, we just found that she wasn't there to like with us, so it kind of was really painful, but it was a good time like, that we got to spend together as a family and all of that. It's been a tough one. Maybe in another video I'll talk about how I've been able to deal with it, you know, dealing with her loss or dealing with loss in general. The steps that I took to, because obviously every day I'm learning how to deal. I wouldn't say I'm there yet. I'm nowhere close to being there yet, but I think every day gets better. The pain never really goes away, but I mean, the time you're able to cope with it, if that makes sense, you're able to cope with the pain. I mean, nobody really goes to me. Not all God's like matching tattoos. So all my sister's best friend, and my dad got matching tattoos. I think it's up here. Yeah. So it's her initial B, and then the day she died. So yeah, if you guys can see it. So yeah, I mean, at the end of the day, we would always have a piece of her. She would always be part of us, and I'm getting a bit emotional, so I'm gonna end the video here. I'll probably be in better spirits in my next video. I do have a lot of content planned for this year. I plan to be more consistent. So if you do want to keep up with me, make sure you subscribe to my channel. Also, I do have plan to have a lot of exciting things for my Instagram as well. So follow me on Instagram if you're not. I'll link my social media platforms down below. So make sure you follow me to keep up with my life, I guess. Follow me. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you for all the messages. A lot of people reached out to me during that period. It was such a hard time for me and my family. But this is the reason why I've been away. I lost my sister. And yeah. I've just been trying to deal with life, deal with work. There's been a lot going on at work. say my personal life as well. Just trying to figure like life out in general. But I'm really looking forward to 2020. I got into this new year being positive, praying, and really hoping for that. I'm really hoping for the best. I believe that the best is yet to come. So yeah, I'm pretty much excited, even though I don't look like I'm excited right now, because obviously I'm emotional about this topic and it's a very touchy subject. So definitely I'm not like in high spirits right now, but I am excited for this year. I can't wait for this year. Thank you guys so much for supporting me. Thank you to my friends that were actually there for me when this whole thing happened. Like, I had a lot of friends. I feel like that experience really taught me who my friends are. You know, a lot of people were present, a lot of people not so much, but it's okay. Like, I think everybody deals with death differently, so it's fine. Yeah, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.
I come before my Lord.